Somebody said that. It's a very short message. He said, I have a friend who sells vibrator. And he said his highest customers are pastors' wives. God is my witness. It was a WhatsApp message. I am not surprised, though. No, I am not. It is you that surprised. I'm not surprised at all. Because you see, a lot of them has no balance between family life. And even some of the pastor's wife who are not doing this thing is spirituality. And the reason is because some of them, in attempt of doing the ministry and everything, has never given these things attention. Statistically, they believe that most of the marriages in the generation ahead of us, 50% will not work. But I realized that most of the problem, it comes with X. It means that it is dangerous for everybody here to be married and still have any form of communication. I'm not saying someone in a yakaba cut off from the person completely. Completely. You shouldn't have anything. No cause. You shouldn't, block his number. You have to treat him like an enemy and keep him in a distance. No access. That is the way you handle it. But unfortunately, most of them are doing it. They're on communication with them. Because let me tell you something. The world is not the way you think 20 years ago. You can be in your bedroom or in America by Skype, by all kinds. Technology has brought us. It has made the world very small. I'm telling you, technology. This guy always used example that he took a picture and he sent it to his ex-boyfriend. He's married for 5 years. He stood there. I saw the picture. It's not somebody said. The husband said, Papa, look. I watch it like this. And then I turn my eyes. I couldn't talk about the matter. When I saw the thing, from that day, I couldn't continue talking about the matter again. He said, my mother nailed her naked. He said, the way your wife took naked picture, I'm also sitting naked. If you sleep with this woman, you are cursed. I carry you for 8-9 months. When I saw that dimension, I told myself, go and pray. Me too, and pray. Prayer versus prayer. The rest, we leave it for God. Serious matter. What on earth that a young lady marry, and this is why I know the thing is demonic. If he will marry you, why did he leave you? We have a lot of sons and daughters in the church who are prayerful, but they are not thinking. Build boundaries. Don't be sitting in the church, in your matrimonial home, conversing with your ex-girlfriend or ex-boyfriend. No matter how they start, it will be as if you are just talking. It will lead to something. Some people can say, I've been married for 13 years. So it started after 30. The guy has gone now, 13 years he appeared. In the picture of the marriage, 13 years. There is a pastor who divorced his wife in America, and the woman starts committing adultery when their marriage was 23 years. You see, we make it look like when you become born again, I see everything has changed. It doesn't. Memories just don't go like that. Your memory gives you the picture of your past. Your imagination gives you the picture of your future. Both of them, God uses them. It is not past. I'm telling you, it's not past. The way you were rolling in the car, it is not gone. Jesus has forgiven you, but the memories are still there. I now understand why God wants us to marry in virginity. When I started hearing that, if a man and a woman marries in virginity, it's that all of them are two greenhorns who have come. This one has no experience. So there is no memories of anything to even bring things about. If there is anything they will see, they watch it from a movie or something, but they have not experienced it. It is different from your practicality.